Hello Pisces, welcome into your singles reading for today. We are going to be looking at your energy currently, and then we're going to have a look and see what's going on around you, get some spirit guide advice out, and at the end of the reading I want to draw a major arcana to see what big changes are coming in your world in the next couple of days or even weeks, what huge shifts will happen. So let's see what's going on here. We've got an Ace of Swords in the reverse position. Single Pisces. This is a card of not being successful at something. This is a card where something has gone wrong here, where you possibly thought that you were going to be, and look what card is under the deck. I've got to take it out. I literally saw it, and I just want to show you the World card is under the deck as well. Where you thought something would come in and be the World, your dream come true, it did not happen. It wasn't successful to get to that World energy, and it felt like something was a failure, or something didn't happen the way that you wanted it to happen. You currently are healing from something here. With the Four of Swords energy, that's that energy of pulling out. It's the energy of stepping back and needing to heal, needing to recover from what this was, from this loss. It's still in your energy. You haven't yet moved past this energy. And remember, when something is still in your energy, it's not easy to get into a new relationship until you sort that out. The next card coming up is the Leo energy here, which is the Strength card in the reverse position. Currently, you are not that strong yet to enter into a new relationship as of yet. And the next card that's sticking out here, the Seven of Cups energy in the reverse position. I feel like you want to be in a relationship, you want to be with somebody, but the timing is so out here. Wow, look at the cards. I'm pulling cards out and this is what comes out here. There is going to be the right timing. Currently, right now, honestly, I love you Pisces so much, but I feel like you still got some healing to do. And you know, this is the weird thing about healing. When we are feeling sad, you know, when we are feeling like we lost something, when we are feeling not strong, this is when we crave for love more than anything. It's when we feel like we need somebody just to hold us and to make us feel better. And it's totally the wrong time for that. Because when we're in a negative space, when we're in a space where we still need to be healed, we will only attract more of that. That is why sometimes you find people keep on getting into one relationship after another, and it keeps on going the same way. It keeps on heading into heartache. And with the Seven of Emotions, it tells me that you really wish to find somebody. It's in the reverse position. It also tells me, with the Seven of Cups, by the way, it also tells me that you do feel lonely. You feel like there is no emotional connection that you have right now. I almost feel like at this moment, it's not the best of energy to get involved in a relationship, because with the Three of Cups in the reverse position, it tells me if you had to go get involved with somebody else right now, in this moment, it would end up hurting you again. It's also like somebody wouldn't really, they would actually be careless with your heart. They would be careless with your heart. You need to be very careful with your own heart right now. You need to protect it and take care of it and nurture that energy so that others can do the same for you as well. Because if you do so, Pisces, you are going to break something here. I feel like you're in the middle of a karmic situation with regards to relationships, with regards to love. This can be what I'm looking at. It can be a blockage that you have. You need to work on that energy. You know, I know we're living in a very practical world. I can touch this candle, I can touch this crystal, but there's another element of this world that we do not see. We pass through it all the time. I mean, we're literally in it, but it's an energetic world. Everything that we see comes from a place of energy. It comes from a place of nothingness. I mean, no, this candle, one day before, it didn't exist. It was not here. Even the body that you're in, there was a time when your body did not exist. It came from that energy. And to get something out of that energy, to manifest it into your world, it's almost like what we give to that energy, the energy just keeps giving it back to us. So we got to make sure that we fix our own vibe. When we fix our own vibe, it's when we break karma. You see, you got a very strong strong energy coming through here of you dealing with something karmic here. This can be, for some of you guys, Pisces, this reading is very, very different from any of the others that I've done. I kind of feel like there's more going on here than just singles reading, to be honest. I feel like you could be carrying, for some of you guys, this is generational karma. This can be a repeating cycle that your mom, your dad, your grandmother, your grandfather have been having in their own relationships. It's almost like you might be coming from a family where you couldn't find that strong relationship. If that's you, then you're dealing with generational karma that needs to be healed, and you're carrying the weight of that from the previous generations. And it's like almost like, you know, you see the cycle happen with people when they get into abusive relationships. The mother was in the abusive relationship, the father. Then you find out the grandparents, they were in that kind of relationship as well. And it just gets passed down from one to the other. That's something, if you know about it and you start to realize what it is that's happening, you can also work on healing it from that perspective. Because if you don't have information about it, you can't do anything about it. But when you know about something and you go, I think that's actually what's happening to me, that's when you can start... I'm working on it. And can I just give you a little hint? I know we're going off topic a little bit here, but I feel like this is why I do the readings anyway, to tell you guys stuff about what spirit guides tell me. When you do so, when you realize you might be having a generational karma, the way to begin to start to heal the karma is to honor the past generations. Is to take out the photos of the people from the past that may not be here anymore. It's to kind of like acknowledge the pain that they went through. I learned this in a moment, actually, from my own spirit guides. I remember one day I was very upset. I was crying about something, of course, a relationship, duh. And my spirit guide said, do you remember your grandmother? And I was just like, my grandmother, what has this got to do with anything? He said, do you know how much she cried? And I was like, yeah, I guess she did. I mean, there was a lot of hard things happening in her world as well. And he said, you know, she's gone now. Does anyone ever think about the tears that she shed? And I was like, no, no one ever does. And he says, that's how you heal this. And I realized you have to honor them. You have to honor the pain that they suffered in the past as well, because it's still there. It still exists in time somewhere, and you have to send your compassion to them. Even if, you know, you light a candle for them, you put up like, you make a little section of your house, like a little altar area, and you put up those images of these people, of unknown tears that they cried that is no longer remembered, and you honor them and you send them your compassion, your love, and even forgiveness. It helps to break generational karma. Whatever this is for you, there is definitely something going on here with regards to this, and you are, I think, on the brink of breaking this because of the justice card being there. And this is actually a very positive reading. If you do this, you're going to clear a blockage. Even if this is a past life karmic situation, honor the past life that you don't even remember and ask healing for that as well. There is so much more going on in the world that we live in, so much more happening. Because look at the card that's coming up here, literally the Seven of Water. If you do so, you are going to change the Seven of Cups in the reverse position to the Seven of Cups in the upright position. There will be changes that come into your world. You will be able to make decisions about your future and what you want to, where you want to go. I like the way it says here, a complex decision, a need to do research. And honestly, I feel like the need to do research has got to do with what I was just telling you. Stop procrastinating, get it done. It is going to open up your world. Yeah, this has definitely got to do with karma. You got a Five of Water that's coming up here. This is definitely a karmic situation. It can be healed. You can do this. I just got to tell you something. If you do have a generational karma, comment below. Let me know. I want to check this comments out here, because I think a lot of people have it and they don't know that they have it. If you break it in your lifetime, the implications of it, it's quite astounding. It's amazing, because you don't only heal you. You heal everybody who came before you. Wow. You even heal the people that are still coming. You heal the next generation as well. And let me tell you something, for this, for you to do this would be unbelievable. I'm actually feeling emotional in your reading, dude. It's like, wow. Okay, Deborah, get a grip. It's just because I'm feeling the weight of what this is. And it literally says, yeah, things not turning out the way that you hoped. This is the Five of Cups energy. not seeing the positive in a situation, crying over spilled milk. For a lot of you guys, this karmic thing that you are carrying is either generational or it's past life karma. Send love to this energy. Love is the strongest force on the planet. And you, in doing so, will release the pain that was. Even not for you, but it's having implications on your life. To heal this, you send love to it. Through time, through space, there is no time and space. It doesn't exist. Your people, your past life people, are currently living that life now. And so are you living this life now. I know it's very complicated, but if you look at it as if they are alive somewhere, living the pain that you were talking about, and you send them love from where you are, you're helping them. And they, in turn, will change your life as well. It's just like a ricochet effect. It's amazing. You do this, I promise you, you are going to see like the most unbelievable. You got the death card coming in. Yeah, you're going to see the most unbelievable change in your life that you've ever seen. I don't often pick this up in readings, and when I do, I'm talking from experience here. What I feel here, I know what it is because I've had this in my own life. And when you heal it, you won't know who you are after that. You won't even recognize your life. And it will be so positive because here is your death energy. It says literally life experience, Archangel Tramiel's energy. This is major. I feel like you're going to do it. It says a significant life event. Yes. A powerful revelation that leads to change. So, wow, this is beyond a singles reading, guys. A time to spread your wings. And this is, this change, this healing that you do for yourself is going to change your entire life. And this has got to be the most positive reading that I've ever done on YouTube. I just got to say thank you guys for coming in. Like, share this reading. If you know another Pisces that's got this problem, even if this person is not Pisces, I'm just going to put this one out there. If you know somebody who's got this problem, share this video to them, even if they're not Pisces. I feel like this just needs to be heard by maybe somebody else as well. It is going to help them and you as well. And I'm wishing you all the best moving forward with the situation, with your life. I feel like you are going to get this right, and the shift and the change that you see will totally astound you. There we go, Pisces. I am sending my love to all of you out there, and I'm wishing you all the best moving forward. Bye, guys.